Like the rest of the internet, HTTP itself is evolving. It's a venerable standard. We've been using it for decades, and it's driven a lot of innovation online. But we're innovating in this space as well. So there's a new standard out that's going to define potentially the next generation of the HTTP protocol, and that's something called HTTP 2. So the current version of HTTP is 1.1. That's sort of the current up-to-date version. And HTTP 2 is designed to address some limitations of HTTP 1.1 that are pretty well understood at this point. And some of those limitations have to do with how browsers fetch and retrieve the resources that are needed to retrieve a page. So how does this work in the HTTP 1 world? So, you know, here's my client over here, and here's the server somewhere on the internet. And the first thing my client has to do is request, you know, some page from the server, and then the server sends that page back. And then usually we know that that page requires other resources to load. So now the client has to open up another connection to request, you know, some sort of CSS file, and that gets sent back. And then I have to open up another connection to maybe request the JavaScript that the page needs to run. And what's going on here? What are some of the problems with this protocol? Well, the protocol, as the HTTP 1.1 protocol is written, requires lots of separate transactions between the client and the server to retrieve this one page. So first I get the HTML content, then I have to issue separate requests for a bunch of other parts of the file. If you go to a complicated page and open up the Chrome developer console and look at the network waterfall diagram that occurs when you load that page, you can see there's all sorts of tiny little requests that are filtering out all over the internet that are required to retrieve just this one page. So how does HTTP 2 improve on this situation? Well, the real goal in HTTP 2 is to try to do as much as possible with as few round trips as possible. Because one of the problems here with this model is that all of these separate connections that I have open to the server, those connections take time to establish. Remember, sometimes the TCP doesn't start to use the full bandwidth of the connection right away, so the connection can be slow initially. And there's all these round trips that have to go. So I have to ask the server for a part of the page, the server responds, I ask it again, it responds again. If your round trip time between you and the server is small, this isn't that big of a concern. But if you're connected to the internet in a way where your round trip time is large, then this can make it very, very, very slow to load pages. And if you have ever been on your phone and you've been on a page that takes a long time to load, a lot of times what's happening is that the page requires lots of these types of round trips, and some of them are very, very slow. And so the browser is waiting for data from the server to render the page, and until it gets all these pieces together, it can't do any work, and sometimes the page even just seems totally broken. So how do we fix this in HTTP 2? So the goal here, right, is really to try to replace as many of these round trips with one round trip, and also to avoid creating lots of new TCP connections. So the first thing that's going to happen in the HTTP 2 world is the client is going to open up a single connection to the web server. And it's going to use that connection for all of the resources that it needs for this page. So it might say, you know, send me index.html, and the server responds, and then it might say, can I also have the next part of the page, the CSS file, and the server responds. But now, rather than requiring multiple TCP connections to be opened, I'm doing it over a single connection. And HTTP also includes ways to avoid having one part of the site block other parts of the site. So I have one connection, so that's really good. The other really interesting and exciting part of HTTP 2 comes with something that you may have realized, which is that, you know, let's say I'm requesting a page from this server. When the server returns the page HTML contents, the server knows that I need these other things, right? So it's kind of, you're kind of like scratching your head. Why do I have to ask the server for all this stuff, right? Shouldn't the server know that in order to render this page, I also need this CSS file and this JavaScript file and some other things? And assuming that those files are coming from the same server, which is common, why does the server make me ask for all this stuff? It knows I need these documents. I mean, come on, help me out a little bit. So that's another really exciting part about HTTP 2 is this idea of server, what's it called, server push. And the idea here is that in certain cases, the server can actually send me documents that I didn't ask for. So I never issued a GET request for these documents, but the server knows I'm going to need them. So in this case, how would this work? So again, all over a single connection to avoid these issues with TCP, I go to the server and I request index.html. But the server knows that I need the CSS and the JavaScript and other resources that are required by this page. So rather than just sending me index.html and making me ask for all that other stuff, it sends me index.html, and then it pushes the other resources at me. And this is the server push part. So it sends on the same wire site.js and site.css, and maybe there's images that this page needs. And so there's something very interesting about this, which is, you know, I'm rather than having to issue all these GET requests, I'm receiving data from the server that preemptively, the server knows I need this information, and in a lot of cases it makes a lot more sense to send it to the client even before it's asked for. Because now there's really only one round trip involved. I made one request, and in one response, I get all of the data back that I need to render this page. So this is HTTP2, pretty exciting. Certainly there will be other versions of HTTP that will be emerge in the future to meet for future needs, but HTTP2 responds fairly well to some well-understood needs and well-understood problems with HTTP1.